गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. माई सेल्फ माई नेम इज डॉक्टर वृशाली देश पांडे. आई एम एम डी इन आयुर्वेदा. गुड मॉर्निंग. हाउ आर यू ऑल? सो माई आई एम प्रैक्टिसिंग इन बैंगलोर सिंस लास्ट 10 ईयर्स एंड आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड माई पी जी फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट आयुर्वेद कॉलेज पोरदार. सो फॉर फ्रॉम मुंबई इट सेल्फ. So I'm very much attached to Mumbai. First of all, I want to congratulate all of you because you have shown the courage and strength to fight against Corona. So we are really thankful to you. So what we are going to start today is how to boost your immunity so that we can fight not only against the Corona, but whatever the infections, whatever the impurities around us, so the only way from our side is to improve our immunity so that we can't get affected with such infections every now and then. Because after every seven, 8 years or 5 years, previously it was Ebola, then previously it was something else. So we are facing a lot of these health issues or challenges. So we want to overcome all of these things. So we are going to concentrate on our immunity. So for this, we have today's agenda. We will go through the COVID introduction first, the measures which are we are getting from every media or the government also. So we'll go we'll just take a slight idea of about it because we are getting inputs from everywhere. Then we'll go for the immunity, the modern Ayurveda aspect. Then we will go for the Agni or the digestive fire concept. So successively we'll reach till the food part. So food in the form of immunity booster. So for these presentations, I think we have 30-40 minutes with us. Is that correct, Sneha?
Yes, doctor. We have 40 minutes around for the presentation and then we will have a 10-15 minutes of question answer round.
Okay, sure.
Okay.
Yeah. Meanwhile, also
want to start the presentation.
Sorry? Yeah.
You want me to begin?
Yeah. So please go through the first slide.
Presentation.
Yeah.
Yes, 1 minute, doctor. Can you see the screen?
Yeah, we are able to see the screen.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, this second slide, please.
Yeah, sure.
So we'll go through this COVID-19. Then we'll go through the immunity first, then how to improve it. The digestive fire is the key factor. Then we will go through the boosters of the immunity, the food, and the do's and don'ts during this period. The next slide, we can see the seesaw. On one end, the coronavirus is there, and the other end, we are seeing some words. So even if we switch on the TV, we get almost 80-90% of the negative news about the corona. But what I feel is, even this pandemic situation, we are getting the opportunity to recreate our world. We are getting, as a community, we are getting closer together. We have started caring about the community, the other people. They should not get infected. We are getting more and more awareness about the health. That's the reason we all are here today. Then we are getting time for ourselves, our family members also. Then the communication is improving. Even some fights are there. Then the humanity and my example is, we can see, I have started respecting my husband more than the previous because I am seeing him on the calls, 24 hours. He is struggling with his team to get the everything at his place, even this during this pandemic situation. And likewise, he has also started having the respect about, I'm managing my patients on video calls, the kids, the family, the house chores. So what I mean to say is, we are getting the positive attitude in our life, which we had lost for so many years. Next slide, please. Here we will see the same instructions are there. So we have so the thing is, we all are at home, so we have to take care of all the touch surfaces at home, like the floor, like the gate, the doorbell, then the handle of all these doors, switches, switchboards. So we have to disinfect all these things again and again. Then the phone and key, all these things, they are come in the same. Then we should go for, then we should take precautions of the droplet infections also, the sneezing, the coughing. We should take care of our children. We should take care of our elderly citizens, our parents, our in-laws. At the same time, the thing is, there is no routine as such, because no one has to go anywhere. There is no office time, there is no school time. So people are wondering, the clock, what you can say, has been stopped. We don't know what to follow, at what time we have to get up, the breakfast, the lunch, dinner, everything. So we should take care of all these things. Then avoid the visitors, maid, drivers. We can meet them outside our house. We should not call them inside. All these things we should take care of. Then washing the hand for 20 seconds. Then social distancing about 3 feet, about 1 meter, that we already know. Next slide, please.
We are unable to see the slide.
Sir, just pin Sneha, you can see it. I've just sent a message on the group. Pin Sneha, you can see the slides.
Now you are able to see?
Not yet, ma'am.
You're done? So we'll go through the immunity. So basically, what is the immunity? Immunity is the entity, or immunity is the power of our own body to fight against any diseases or anything, any foreign body or any autoimmune disorders also. So if the body goes out of balance, whatever the reactions, whatever the pathology, whatever the process happens in our body, it's called as our immune system. So basically, we can categorize the immunity in two types. First is innate immunity. Innate is our inborn immunity, which is we are inheriting from our parents. So it is inborn. So we can't do much about it. The second type is the acquired immunity. So acquired immunity is the immunity which we are developing over the period of time, during our lifetime, by taking the food, by taking some medicines, or you can say with the improvement of our lifestyle, the exercises, the right daily regime, daily routine. So this acquired immunity, this has again the two types. One is active immunity and the second is passive immunity. So this active immunity is is our own body actually, but the WBCs, these pathogens, they fight against something. Something means the foreign body. So when the organism, it enters our body, the reflex or the reply given from our immune system is called as active immunity. So this can be done with the natural and artificial. So natural is our own antibodies when we get exposed to the infection. Then artificial antibodies, we all are aware of the vaccination. So vaccinations are the dead organisms which we inject in our body to activate the immunity. So this is artificial immunity. And the passive immunity is something else that we acquire from someone. That is again the antibodies which get transmitted through the mother's milk to the baby. So we get that colostrum for initial for 2-3 days from the baby, from the mother, the fresh breast milk, the colostrum, the yellow sticky substance. So through that, the baby will get the natural passive immunity antibodies. Then the artificial antibodies, these are some immunoglobulins, IgG, IgM. So these are some immunoglobulins which are in the form of injections and all. So through this, what we are going to target today is our acquired immunity, which is active and which is natural. So we want to improve our natural immunity, which is active. Are you getting my point? So please say yes, so I can understand. I'll go ahead.
Yes,
yes.
So what here, why we have to concentrate only on immunity and not on the vaccines and all? Because see, vaccines, we can get the vaccines ready by the month of maybe September, maybe October, or we may get a little bit more delay because of this clinical trials going on everywhere in the world. But how many times you are going to find the vaccines again and again and you are getting, but at the same time we are losing so many lives in this battle. So best way is to improve our own natural immunity. So this is the importance of today's lecture, or this is the importance of Ayurveda or alternative medicine, that we should concentrate on our immunity rather than going for any medicine or the vaccine. Next slide, please. So here, so according to Ayurveda, the immunity, we can call it as Oja. So this is a little bit complex to understand, but I will explain you. There are 7 tissues in our body. They like rasa, rakta, mamsa, medha, asthi, majja, shukra. For example, this lymphatic systems, the respiratory system, then our musculature, our muscles, then the body fat, then the bony structures, the bone marrow, and our reproductive system, that is shukra. So the essence of all these 7 dhatus or 7 tissues is called as oja. And that is our strength, or that is our bala. And this is the immunity. So when we talk about oja, when we talk about this bala, unlike the modern medicine, this is the part which contains the physical, emotional, and the spiritual part of our body. A little bit complex to understand, but still we will try to get into it. So this oja is responsible for our physical, emotional, and spiritual well-being. So today we are going to concentrate only on physical, because we are going to concentrate on only on food regimen. There are some emotional and spiritual factors we will go through successively. So this oja has 3 types. This bala has 3 types. Again, sahaj bala, which is innate immunity, I have explained you already. Then the second one, it comes as a kalaj bala or acquired. Here kalaj bala means the infant or the this can be done according to the age also and according to seasons also. There are different kalas. So if we go for our age groups in small children, the immunity is little bit, the bala is little bit less. In adult, the bala is good. In old age, again, the bala goes little bit down. So this is kalaj bala. And season-wise also, when there is a southern celestial or when there is a dakshinayan, when there is half, from the summer to the rainy season or the start of the winter, naturally the body strength is less. And in the winter, the body strength is more. Okay. So then third part is, we can go for yuktikrut bala. So here we are again try to improve our yuktikrut bala. So this can be done by means of food regimen, the healthy lifestyle and exercises. Next slide, please. So now, why food is so much important? So when we eat the food, what happens? When we eat the food, the digestive enzymes, the digestive fire in our stomach, in the first part of our duodenum, the action and reaction happens, and the digestive enzyme or digestive juice is getting prepared. So with this digestive juice, all our these seven tissues, which I explained earlier, this rasa, rakta, mamsa, medha, asthi, majja, shukra, they are getting nourishment from this digestive juice. So with this juice, we will get the physical as well as our mental health. We'll get the nourishment for all these tissues. Some byproducts are getting prepared. They also get the nourishment, just like our nails, our hair. So they are also getting prepared and they are also getting nourishment. So this food is very important because when we eat food, then and then only we are able to prepare this oja or build our immunity. So it gets approximately, so for each dhatu, we can consider about 7 days. The nourishment gets after seven days. So if we eat today, we are getting the nourishment after, say, so for the 3 days. So after we are getting the full dhatus, they are getting nourishment after the 21 days. So if we are going for 3 days as per each and every dhatu, the seven dhatus are there. So rasa will get the nourishment after 3 days, rakta will get the nourishment after 3 days successively. So this oja will get the nourishment after 21 to 30 days. So it's not about exactly the days, but we also know about it that any habit, if we follow something, if we do something, our changes, our lifestyle also, so we will get accustomed to it after 21 days. So if we follow something for 21 days, we will get used to it. So to get this oja strength or bala, we will need 21 to 30 days. Next slide, please. So for this, we want to understand our digestive fire. So we can categorize our digestive fire into three types according to the individual constitution. There are types of agni or this digestive power, the vishamagni, tikshnagni, and mandagni. I'll explain you in detail. The second phase is understanding the food, what are the boosters, what is the balanced diet. The third phase, we will go for what should be our routine and what should we incorporate in our daily diet. Next slide, please. So this digestive fire, it has types. So everyone, now you have to find out what is you are type of Agni. You can do it with your self-analysis also. I'll just briefly tell you. Vishamagni, the person, if the person is suffering from gas, bloating, again and again, constipation, and if the person is not able to follow the eating schedule or whatever the diet, or if you're feeling hungry on the various timings during a day, then your Agni is Vishamagni. This is not bad or good. This is your constitution. This is your Prakruti. So for this, we can tell the instruction that you should not eat any cold or any raw food, which will increase this tendency. Then the Tikshanagni comes. So this Tikshanagni, when you suffer from a little bit of loose motion, heartburn, then little bit of acid indigestion every now and then the person is supposed to have Tikshanagni. Tikshanagni person will feel hungry again and again. In spite of that, he will have such symptoms like heartburn and indigestion. Still, he feel hungry. So this is Tikshanagni. So for this, you should avoid the spicy food, and you should go for fruits and leafy vegetables, more and more cooling agents. The third Agni is Mandagni. It is for some people, even if they don't eat much, it is very easy to gain the weight. So their tendency, body tendency is like that only. Even if they don't eat, they will keep on putting weight more and more. So their digestive fire has been little bit on weaker side as compared to this Tikshanagni. So for them, they should avoid the fried and protein rich food, because their digestive system will go into pressure, or they can't handle the pressure of heavy food. Then the Samagni, when the person is swastha, healthy, he will have the normal Agni. Next slide, please. So when we talk about food, what we generally eat, so we have so many categories, like we are talking about these carbohydrates, fats, proteins, and then vitamins, minerals, so all these groups. So these are, we are getting all these things from different subgroups. So these are typically in our Indian food, the vegetarian food, typically it consists of grains. So this rice, wheat, barley, these all comes under the grains. Then this dairy products, all these milk products, curd and cheese and all, comes under dairy product. Then the beans and legumes, whatever the dal we eat, moong dal, masoor, toor and everything, it comes under dal. Nuts and seeds, all these almonds, peanuts, cashews. Then fruits, fresh fruits, vegetables, meats, non-vegetarian food, oils, sugars and spices. So these are the main classes. So now this, each and every food has 20 attributes. These 20 attributes are, for example, like these are the properties like heavy to digest, light to digest, hot for the body, cold for the body, like that 20 attributes are there. And these 20 attributes, they are similar to our body tissues. So whatever the same attribute, it increases the same tissue, and it decreases, and whatever the opposite qualities are there, they decrease the that typical body tissue. Then again, we should incorporate all the six types, all the six tastes in our daily diet. These are tastes like sweet, sour, salty, pungent, astringent, and bitter. So our food, our meal, it should incorporate all six tastes. many times it happens that we just eat like rice and dal and we don't eat anything else, or we just have one of my patient, he was fond of dosa. So he eats every day dosa, every day breakfast dosa. But what happens is all the six rasas, all the six taste, they are not going. So he is not getting nourishment from all these doshas. So we should incorporate all these six tastes. How we should, we will see in next slide. So all six tastes, it brings you the health, good health. Nityam sarva rasabhyasaha swaswadhikya mrutavrutav. That is the saying in Ayurveda, that you should incorporate all six tastes. So now here we can see two parts. Here the big red for all this full platter of sweets, and then curd, then this rice, roti, and so many fried things are there. You can see this platter. So like we can say like Rajdhani Thali or something. So instead of this, we should concentrate on this each group, and we should take whatever the best from each food group. So from this grains, we can take the rice, we can cook the rice, we can remove the upper part of the water so it will get easy to digest. Then the moong dal is the best from all the pulses. Barley is good. It is called as yav in Ayurveda. Jav or yav, or Hindi jav you can call. So this is very good. Then sandhav salt we should eat. for the non-vegetarian people, we have the option of chicken soup, which is easy to digest. It enkindles your agni, digestive fire, and it will give you benefit of non-vegetarian food. At the same time, it will take out all the toxic effects of the meat. Then the fruit, the best fruit is amla. Honey we can take in the sugar group, and the ghee in the dairy. It is the best. So these food we should incorporate in our daily diet as much as possible. Yes, so if we eat such kind of food, we will not face much of the illness, much of the diseases. And even if you feel, we will come out of it as early as possible. So here the Sanskrit verse is there. Shashtikan Shalimudgamsha Sendhava Malake Yavan Antariksha Payasarpi Jangalam Madhucha Abhyaset. The next slide, please. So how do we start our meal? First of all, it has been described in Ayurveda that we should eat one appetizer before we start our meal. What is that appetizer? That appetizer is very easy. It is very easy to make at home. We can have the ginger. We can have fresh ginger. We can grate that ginger. We can add a little bit of sandhav salt into it, and we can just lick it before our meal, especially after the heavy meal, the lunch. So bhojanagare sada pratpathyam lavanardraka bhakshanam. It is the principle. So you should always have ginger and sandhav at your fingertip before starting the meal. Then you can have your meal. Then when to stop? When to stop is the key factor in our food. So when to stop? So our stomach, if we consider our stomach, so we should eat only 75% of its capacity, including the liquids. So we should keep the 1/4 of our stomach. We should keep the 25% of our stomach free for the gases to move around. So when, how do we understand that we are 75% of full capacity? So any healthy individual, which is having normal agni function, normal digestive function, he will experience the first burp when he completes his meal 75%. This is little bit difficult to practice, but I hope we have gone through that 21 days theory. So if you follow all these things, and even if you take at least one principle from here, it would be very helpful for your health in future. So don't eat full. That is the key factor. You should feel satisfaction, and you should not feel the fullness of your tummy. That is the key factor. Such in such a way, if we take the meal, it will give nourishment to all our body tissues. It will balance this three attributes of Vata, Pitta, Kapha in our body, and it will give proper nourishment to at the tissue level also, and the assimilation will be proper. Whatever the bala or whatever the strength we are getting from the food, that we will get without any interruption. So what should be done at the end of the meal? So at the end of the meal, especially after lunch, we can have a glass full of buttermilk. We can spice it with the ginger. We can spice it with the black pepper, cumin powder, and all that we can. I'll explain later the spices. Then we should go for the next slide, please. So here are some herbs which we usually, here are some spices we usually on daily basis we use it in our food. That's why the Indian food, that's why all our recipes, they are giving us a strength. But in this COVID situation, we should use all these things little bit in more quantity. So here we will go in short each and every spices. Like for example, we will go for this garlic. So what this garlic does, this garlic is it reduces the fever. It has antimicrobial activity, fungal also. It reduces the abdominal pain, it removes the kapha, it destroys the toxins, and it is very good for rejuvenation. Many people which have problem with their nerves, which have problem of this sciatica, we recommend them to have garlic boiled in the milk and then have it early in the morning every day. So it reduces the nerve pain, it reduces the inflammation on the nerves, and it gives relief in the inflammation. So we can use this, as I told in the recipe, especially with the milk and garlic you can have. We call it as rasamuk shirpak. We can use that. Or we can add it in various curries, in vegetables. Then we can go for turmeric. Turmeric is very useful for the diabetes, as you know. Anemia, it controls the fever also. It is an excellent blood purifier. It destroys the poison also. So that's why Ayush Ministry has also recommended every day that we should eat the turmeric as much as possible. We should take this healthy milk or the turmeric milk at bedtime, especially for the senior citizens, especially for the kids who have the tendency of producing more and more kapha and mucus. So we can use this haldi in the milk in the form of almost every recipe contains haldi. We can use it in the form of pickle also. We can use it in the form of raita also. We'll get this fresh haldi in the market in the form of it just looks like ginger, but it is deep yellow or orange in color. So we can use this fresh turmeric. At the same time, if it is not available, you can use the powder also. Then we can go for clove. So everyone knows clove for the dental pain. As it reduces the pain, it is good carminative also, it is antifungal. If you are traveling, if you have this motion sickness, you are asked to keep one clove in your mouth to avoid this morning sickness also, and then the motion sickness also. So pregnant women also, if they are suffering from this morning sickness, this chewing clove is helpful. At the same time, it improves the digestive fire. It benefits the throat. Ayush Ministry also has recommended taking clove powder with the honey, 1 to 2 grams, twice or thrice in a day. So powder to be used in the spice. We can add it to the rice. We can add it to the pulao, and we can take it with the honey as well. Then the next is mint. It reduces the pain. It is excellent deepana and excellent pachana. So we all know that pudin hara. So mint is supposed to calm down the gases from our tummy, the gaseous distension. It reduces the pain which is associated with indigestion. Methods we can take it in the inhalation form. We can steam the leaves and we can take that inhalation. It is excellent bronchodilator also. It clears our nasal mucosa in the nose, in our sinuses. It gives soothing effect. Then we can use mint in the form of chutneys. We can make the sharbat also. The next we will go for this black karavi or this Krishna jeerak, we call it as. These are the seeds of the onion. So these are diuretic, that it cleanses the bladder, the urinary bladder. It is an excellent expectorant. It is an excellent bronchodilator. It opens up the bronchial tree. It melts down the kapha, the mucus secretions. So that's why it is very good for our respiratory system. You can add it in the tadka. You can add it in the all the vegetables. You can add it in the soup. You can add it in the in your dal also. Next slide, please. Here we can see the lemon, ginger, black pepper, tulsi, and cinnamon. So our government ministry has prepared a very good combination out of this 4 herbs. The Ayush ministry has recommended everyone to drink this decoction, or we call it as kashaya or kadha in Ayurveda. So what we can do is we can take 150 ml of water, and we can put all this in proper proportion. I will share with you what exactly the proportion. And we can drink it in the morning and in the evening. So we'll go for this lemon. So lemon, we all know it is a good antioxidant. It is good decongestant. It is good antiseptic. It has a rich source of vitamin C. The flavonoids, which it peels contains, that actually burns the fat. So early in the morning, if you incorporate lemon in your daily regime, if you take in the warm water, if you squeeze just lemon in the warm water and you can drink it, it will be a very nice morning drink for you, which will give you antioxidant effects. So method, you can have, as I told, lemon juice you can have, lemon pickle you can have on a daily basis. You can eat lemon pickle because we can make the pickle of lemon without any oil, without extra chilies, without extra salt. So with peel also we can make the pickle. We can garnish the lemon in each and every dish, whatever we prepare. Then we will go for this ginger. As you already know, ginger is very good as a digestive. It prevents nausea also. Again, it increases the digestive fire. It reduces the coughing. Whatever the breathing difficulties are there, that also eases out by the means of ginger. We can use in the form of vegetables. We can grate the ginger. We can make a paste of ginger with garlic. We are already using in lots of vegetables, this curries and salads and soups and dal. In Ayurveda, ginger is supposed to be described as Vishwabheshaja. So Vishwabheshaja is, it is a universal remedy. So now in this COVID pandemic, if we eat more and more ginger, the dry form of ginger is called as shunthi. So shunthi is a Vishwabheshaja. and we should eat as much as possible, especially when we are now we are going to face rain or this rainy season very soon. With this COVID pandemic and this rain, especially in Mumbai, we will need such fighters with us. So we can have this Ayush Kwath or Ayush Kashai or this boiled water just with chunti powder or ginger. It will serve the purpose. Then the next is black pepper. So black pepper, how many of you remove the black pepper from the soup or from the rice or from the vegetables? We have so many people, or our kids also, old age people, they have habit of keeping the black pepper out of our whatever the recipe is, because it is little bit what you can say strong aroma, and it is little bit very you can say pungent, dam tikha. So instead of putting whole black pepper, what we can do is we can make the powder and then we can put it. So this is the best way to have black pepper in our body. Black pepper is very good for our throat. It is very good cough reducing, and it improves the digestive fire. It is one of the great ingredient of trikatu churna in Ayurveda. Trikatu churna is the combination of this black pepper, ginger and the pimpri, and this is the best appetizer. So what method we can use? You can just I told you, powder you can use in the spices, we can put it the rice, we can put this in the soups also. Suppose we are making the corn soup for the kids, we are making some vegetable soup for the kids, we can make the powder of this black pepper and we can use it. It is excellent for our cough, excellent for our upper respiratory system. The next comes tulsi, the holy basil. We all know the antibacterial property of tulsi. It eases the breathing. Even I am using the concentrated tulsi drops in daily drinking water. It reduces the coughing. It is good carminative. So it kills some bacteria. It kills some germs also. It is an excellent expectorant. It reduces the fever. In each and every cough syrup of Ayurveda, this tulsi has been combined with vasa. So method we can have, we can use this in the form of kada or herbal tea, and we can add it in the curries also. The next is cinnamon. It increases the appetite. It is very good for the diabetes people. It increases the strength. It is good expectorant. We can use it in the form of vegetables. We can make the powder. We can sprinkle it on any of your payasam recipe of kheer or some milk recipe. We can just season it with the cinnamon powder. We can use it with the banana also. Next slide, please. So what I mentioned earlier, this agni types, this vishamagni, tikshnagni and mandagni. So these herbs we can use in moderation for the people who are having tikshnagni, because some herbs, they are when we consider when our Indian spices come, many Western people, many people they say that the spices, Indian spices, are very strong. They are very pungent. We can't tolerate it. So the same case happens for this tikshnagni people, which are having predominantly the pitta constitution. They are little bit they can tolerate this in a little bit moderation as compared to this vishamagni and mandagni. So mandagni, the people who are having kapha constitution, who are having kapha in their body more, they can have these herbs. And this vishamagni, this vata people, they can have then whatever the quantities I'm going to share all these with you, so you can use these herbs according to this dosage. Next slide, please. So now here comes the daily routine.
Sorry interrupting, madam. What is this green and yellow?
So the green is, we can use it easily, whatever the dosage has been there, has been written. And for this yellow, they are having little bit problem if they take it in the excess. For example, this Tikshnagni, some people, this Pitta people, they have a tendency of hyperacidity. So with this garlic and turmeric, they may face little bit more acidity if their Pitta is already increased. At the same time, they will feel cool when they use mint because it is green. So I'm for just understanding purpose, I have taken this color code. Then this ginger is for Vishamagni. It is if it is used, it should be used fresh, as it is not that strong. But for the Mandagni, it should be used in the powder form. When you use ginger in the powder form, you should eat the minimum quantity, as it is very strong as compared to fresh. So Sundha is more stronger than ginger. Next slide, please. So here comes the daily routine. What we should do, what we should eat. So first of all, in the morning, after emptying our bowel, everything, what to drink. So we are fond of this tea, coffee. Without that, we can't move ahead in our day. So this is the time where we can change this routine. We can change our addiction. We can switch over to better options. We can switch over to warm water with lemon. You can add this lemon, dry ginger powder, honey as a booster, and you can take it empty stomach.
Sorry to interrupt, can we have the previous slide, because you are explaining the previous slide. Yeah, thanks.
So the slide is going on right now is the meal time, right? Sneha, are you there?
Yes, doctor.
Yeah. So we should drink warm water early in the morning. We can put this honey, lemon, or dry ginger powder as a booster, as an immunity booster. Then we can have our breakfast. Breakfast you should take as early as possible, but at the same time, you should wait the hunger. You should feel hungry. It's not just the breakfast time is there and you have to eat. It's not the way. You should first see if you are really hungry, then only you can have breakfast. Before breakfast, during this Kapha Kala, during this 6 to 8 a.m., that is your self time. It is time for healing. You can have the exercise routine. You can do the Surya Namaskara, the meditation, pranayam, and everything. So that is the time which is secured for you. Then after that, you will be busy with your daily routine, your offices, your calls. So in the morning time, you can have this exercise routine. So do you take warm water or this herbal tea or this Ayush Kashai or this honey lemon combination with warm water? Then you can go for your exercise routine, and then you can switch over. Then you can wait till you feel hungry and you can have your breakfast. One more thing I want to tell you here. We should not eat whatever the recipes with the fruit. So we should not take fruit and this breakfast menu. For example, this poha upma. And apple, poha, upma, and oranges. So we should not combine whatever the recipe and the fruit together. At the same time, we should not eat this milk and this recipes together. Okay, that I'll explain you afterwards why it is that so.
So, doctor, sorry to interrupt.
Yeah.
Just a question.
Yeah.
first is the warm water, then you can take tea, coffee. Any time gap between the two?
See, you can have 30 minutes in between. Tea, okay. Coffee also, I would recommend that you should go for a herbal tea. Most of the times, you can have this tulsi tea, ginger tea, green tea or cinnamon tea instead of going for tea, coffee.
You're saying 30 minutes time gap between warm water and tea, coffee.
Yes. So immediately after emptying your bowel, you can have warm water with these boosters. And one more thing, this Ayush Ministry has explained in the circular that you should eat Chyawanprash as a immunity booster. But the thing is, you should feel hungry. You should be able to digest the Chyawanprash. So what I recommend is, you should follow this warm water with shunti, warm water with dry ginger or this herbal teas. You wait for the hunger, good hunger. Whatever the whatever I explained earlier, some like burps are coming. If you are having acidity issues, if you are feeling that your tummy is upset, then you should not eat Chyawanprash. So Chyawanprash, because there is a combination of more than 100 herbs in Chyawanprash. It is the extract of amla with other herbs, with the ghee. So you should have good agni. You should have good digestive power in order to digest Chyawanprash. So what I recommend is, you should go for this 10 to 15 days of initial routine for this Ayush Kashay or this decoction, these herbal teas. And then you should successively start this extra boosters for the immunity.
Thank you, Doctor.
Yeah. So we will go for the next slide. So here they have explained how to prepare this Ayush Kashay, this Ayush Kwath or decoction. Very, very simple. You can have this tulsi leaves. If you are not able to find out the tulsi leaves, if you are not able to procure it, you can order this tulsi powder. You can have this 4 parts. You can make dalchini powder 2 parts, that is cinnamon. You can have shunti 2 parts and black pepper 1 part. You can take 150 ml of water, and you can put this powder, mixture of powder, you can boil it. And you can have it once or twice in your daily routine. So this is this tastes also good. It is not bitter. So old age people, this small kids also, they can have this. You can add little bit of lemon. You can add little bit of jaggery. You can put the black raisins to season it little bit on those sweeter side. So the people can easily take it. 2-3 more easily adaptable lifestyle changes Ayurveda is recommending during this pandemic. We should apply some form of oil, maybe sesame, maybe this gingerly oil, or you can put this coconut oil, almond oil will also work, or little bit ghee. You just put, you just take on your little finger, and you just put this both into your both the nostrils. Before that, you should wash your hands for 20 seconds with the soap, and you should take that oil and you should put into both your nostrils morning and evening. So whatever the pathogens, whatever the viruses are there, they won't be able to enter our nasal mucosa and our body. Then the second thing they recommend, the oil pulling therapy. This is also very easy. Just like gargle, or just like you take 1 teaspoon or 2 teaspoons of warm gingerly oil or sesame oil or this coconut oil, you can put it in your mouth like this. You can put it for this 2-3 minutes. You can put the gargle, you can circulate it in the full nasal cavity, the mouth cavity like this. You can put little bit of, you can do little bit of gargle also like this. And then you can spit it out. This also, you can do it once or twice in a day so that the immunity of the throat will increase. And whatever the whatever the, what you can say, the dirt toxins are there, they will get out of your throat. For the sore throat and all, the combinations they are suggesting with the mint and with this karavi or this onion seeds, you can have the steam inhalation. Next slide, please. So now, we will come to this post-breakfast routine. So now in post-breakfast routine, again, we have to wait till we feel hungry. Otherwise, this is going to cause our digestive problems. It will upset our digestive system. Because if you eat, even if you don't feel hungry, what will happen is your undigested food is already is in your alimentary canal. And if you are eating fresh food on top of that, your digestive mucosa will not be able to absorb whatever the nutrients are getting. So you should wait till you feel hungry. Ideal time for the lunch is 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. I know everyone is at home, so we are a little bit of lazy to have our routine in place, just like it was there before the corona. But we should concentrate on these things like 11 to 1 p.m. We should have our lunch. Just I told you before that before our meal, we should have that ginger and sandhav paste. We have to lick it so our digestive fire will get enkindled, and it will be very helpful for the digestion. And at the end of the meal, we can have a nice glass full of buttermilk with the spices. Again, same thing, I'm reminding you, 75% of your tummy, please remember. So with the buttermilk, we should fill our tummy 75%, and we should keep the 25% for the gases, for the vayu to move around. Then the booster, we can put the vegetables and curries, we can put all these whatever herbs we have discussed before. At the same time, we can put cumin seeds, we can put coriander powder, we can put the coriander leaves also. They are also excellent diuretics. They wash out the toxins out of our bladder. Cilantro or this green coriander is very good. It is a rich source of vitamin A. So you can have that as well. You can make a combination of, you can put extra garlic, extra ginger, extra turmeric into your meal preparation. The extra boosters, you can put this clove, dalchini, mint, methi seeds, till we can put, then hing we can put, ajwain we can put. There are many more things we can list here. After lunch, the strict instruction is do not sleep, because after eating, if you sleep, it will disturb again your digestion. It will accumulate the excess kapha in your tummy, in your stomach lining. It will aggravate the kapha dosha. It will affect your digestion. You will feel more and more sleepy. You will feel more and more heavier, and your digestive issues will not get nourishment. Again, it causes high blood sugar level, the cholesterol depositions, and then you can face many more lifestyle disorders like obesity, PCODs, and many more. So do not sleep during daytime. Then again, the tea or coffee time or in the afternoon, you can have the tea again. So afternoon time is little bit of, you can say little bit of on warmer side, especially in Mumbai. So you can make the combination of coriander powder, cumin powder, and fennel. You can put a little bit of honey also to it. So when this coriander, cumin, and fennel, you can make the mixture of this all three together. And it has a very good aroma. You will like this tea. Please try it. Again, the same thing as we discussed earlier, Ayush Quatha, we can incorporate again in the evening, or we can have just warm water. If you can't do anything, you can just have Nimbu Sharbat with a little bit of warm water. Then the snacks, if small kids are there, they will prefer to have snacks. They can
Why you're asking us stop to drink tea and coffee? What is the reason behind that?
See, basically, tea and coffee, what it does is, it has prepared in the factory. It has many chemicals in it. So while processing tea powder and coffee powder, what happens is many nutrients, whatever the tea coffee has, many nutrients like phosphorus. I know tea and coffee as a herb, they are good. But when in the factory, tea powder and coffee powder has been prepared, what happens is potassium, then magnesium, many more micronutrients, they are just getting separated in the factory. And what happens is when we drink these decoctions, our bone or our bone marrow or our bones, it has a tendency to extract that calcium, phosphorus from our bones. So what I feel is, and again, extra sugars with the means of tea, coffee we drink. So what I feel is, you should go for whatever the herbs are there. The warm water and herb combination will be better option as compared to tea and coffee. Tea and coffee, I have seen with my clinical data, with my patients, I have seen many patients who are taking regular tea and coffee. They are suffering from hypertension. They are suffering from many lifestyle disorders. The thing is only that they can't quit, or they can't quit from this tea coffee addiction. See, one or two coffee with minimal of powder is okay. But if you have habit of 4 or 5 cups in a day with sugar, it is not advisable at all. So okay. Once in a while, tea coffee is okay. But during this, especially during this pandemic situation, I will share one more slide where this junk food like chips, then toffees, ice creams, they are just empty calories. They just give us, there is no nutrition at all. So in tea coffee also, it is nutrition-less drink. So we should go for the better option, especially during this pandemic when we want to build our immunity. And this immunity is getting built over the time, over the period, at least 21 to 30 days. So please be aware of it.
How about having black tea, black coffee?
Black tea, black coffee is okay. You can squeeze lemon. You can put little bit of cinnamon powder into it. But again, same thing. Black tea and black coffee, again, it has the same problem. So I would recommend to go for herbal tea, natural teas as much as possible.
Okay.
We were talking about the snacks. So when small kids are there, now they are not able to play outside. They are just sitting at one place. They don't have much physical activity. So at this time, at this point of time, you can give them this puffed rice. We call it as chivda, homemade chivda. You can give this puffed murmura. You can give. Then you can have this popcorn-like thing. Jawar, pop jawar you can give. So you can make the homemade snacks with them. You can give dried dates, figs. So if you give this, they will be able to have their regular dinner, because these things, they are easy to digest. And after eating this, they will feel hungry at the time of dinner. So especially avoid more of a bread, more of biscuits, maida products, bakery products, and you can go for such. Or you can have the fruits also, fresh fruits also you can give at this time. Fruits are not recommended after the sunset. So at night, you should not eat any fruit.
Yeah.
What is the best time to have snacks?
Best time, huh?
Yeah.
So again, same thing. Whatever previously you have taken the lunch, it should get digested 3-4 hours. So ideal time will be around 4:30, 5 o'clock. You can give snacks. So you will feel hungry at the time of dinner around 8 o'clock.
Can we have milk in the evening?
Milk in the evening you can have, but then you can put a little bit seasoning like a haldi or turmeric, something, so that milk will not give you extra kapha. The next slide, please. Again, this is a family time also, so we can spend our time with our parents, our kids, and then we can enjoy this snacks or this meal time. Now this is dinner time, what we should follow. Again, same thing, we should wait till we feel hungry. Ideal time will be 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. What we should take for the dinner. So dinner should be lighter than the lunch. So what should be there in the dinner? We can have a simple khichdi. Khichdi will be again combination of rice and moong dal. So we can roast rice and then we can make the khichdi. So it will become lighter also. It will not give you obesity if you roast the rice and then you make the khichdi or rice out of it. So ideal time will be 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Whatever you can put, the boosters, vegetables, curries with coriander, cumin, ajwain, we can put. So ajwain we can use here. So it will reduces the gases, which are typically we experience more in the evening time, as there is that is a vata kala. So you can put ajwain in the evening supper or evening meal. Extra booster we can have this time, just warm water we can have. We can have warm water with lemon also. We can drink a little bit of Ayush Kwatha also with the dinner. And again, same thing, do not sleep immediately. We should keep the time 2 to 3 hours during our dinner and our bedtime. At bedtime, we should have, as a booster, we can have milk with turmeric. Milk should be fat-free for this elderly people, for normal adult also. If we can get fat-free milk, we can combine it with turmeric and then we can have this warm. Next slide, please. So, in all, we should get a good 7 to 8 hours sleep during this time also. And this sleep should be around 10:30 to 6:30 in the morning. It's not like at whatever time you can sleep, you can sleep at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the night. It's not like that, because our body needs that 10 to 11 to 2 time for the self healing, for the whatever the tissue wear and tear happens, to remove the toxins, to get our circadian rhythm. Our body needs that sleep during that time. So it is mandatory for us not to stay awake at late night and not to go off of balance. The next slide, please. So here comes a little bit of a psychological factor. When we eat food with all these rituals or with all this, what you can say, whatever the rules have been mentioned here, some rules I have taken because of this time constraint, I have taken a small portion of it, but there are many more to add, like how to eat curd, you should not eat at night, and all these things are there. So even if we eat in proper way, the things we will, it will get affected. They are our psychological factors. So food you eat will not well digested if you are worried, if you are sad, if you are having fear, if you are having social stigma, if you are watching TV and if you are now thinking, oh, well, what will happen, this infection and all these things. So I recommend while taking food, while eating, you should off all your media, whatever the gadgets, and you should enjoy the meal with your family together, with some happy moments, with some jokes. We should concentrate on our food, because whatever the food we eat, that we are consuming, we are giving that food for, to our digestive fire. So it is as good as we are performing something homa or something yajna. So we should pay respect. If we pay respect, that food also will be able to give the fullest nutrition to our body. So we should follow all these things. Food you eat will not well digested. Again, this sound sleep, what I have mentioned earlier. So we should get good night sleep. So the last slide here comes about, can you go to the next slide, please? Here the do's and don'ts are there. So nowadays I'm seeing many small kids, they are preferring these chips, this packet food, these Doritos, then popcorns, then whatever the rainbow colored candies, ice creams, then cookies. Everyone is making cakes, bakery and bakery products and everything. So these products, they are just like empty calories. They are going to slowly, they are going to weaken your immunity. So please refrain from them. You can give once in a while, you can give to your kids all these things, but not as a routine, not as a daily routine. Again, one more concept is you should not eat the, you should eat the food with proper combination. Do not consume or eat any fruit at least an hour before or after food. So this fruit will not get with the meal, because the fruit's post-digestive effect, any fruit's post-digestive effect is sour. So our digestive system, our digestive enzymes, they go into confusion. So we should not mix this proportion. We should not mix this combination together. Legumes or dals, we should not eat that with the cheese or eggs. So the plant protein and animal protein we are putting together, that is not acceptable. Milk, sour fruit combination, banana, cherries, melons. So again, the fruit fruit salad or this milkshake combination is not good. It is toxic for our body. Then potato, tomato with the dairy product or cucumber. Yogurt, we should not heat the yogurt. We should not heat yogurt. We should not take it with hot drinks also. We should not eat with lemon also. Then beans with eggs. There are some more combinations here, grains and fruits and hot drinks with mangoes and fish. So if you are having this mango nicely cut, and if you are having this tea, it is not a good combination. So please consider all these things, all these rules while eating. Again, I'm emphasizing, go for the Nitya Sevaniya Dravyas or Nitya Sevaniya food, which I have mentioned earlier. The rice or roti also, if you have to eat, you have to take, you have to make it light to digest. You have to make the fulka roti. Don't go for heavy rotis like naan, chapati, or this, what you can say, this rumali roti, maida roti and all. So just have this wheat roti and the stuffs which is easy to digest.
Doctor?
Yeah.
Do you recommend buffalo milk over cow milk, or is
no? I would recommend cow milk. Cow milk is easy to digest. It has many nutrients over the buffalo milk, so always go for cow milk. Buffalo milk make you a little bit more idle. It is heavy to digest. We call it as guru in our this 20 properties attributes. It is guru to digest. It is heavy to digest.
Madam, we have also heard about A2 milk. Is it the A2 milk is
so beneficial? If you are fortunate enough to get A2 milk, that is recommend. I would recommend A2 milk over normal cow milk. But if you are not getting at all, it is okay to use normal milk than not using at all.
Madam, this is Vijay Kumar. I joined late actually due to personal official commitments.
Okay.
The slide which I saw last was seems to be very good actually, kind of a do's and don'ts.
Yes.
Would you be able to share these kind of some important slides for our reference, madam? Because the last one was really good actually, because we do mistake unknowingly.
Having hot drinks
with along with say, like mangoes or something like that you mentioned with yogurt and things like that. So maybe unknowingly we are meant to be doing certain things like that.
Correct.
So that will be helpful, madam, if you could share.
This is going to be shared with your HR.
So we will be sharing this with your HR along with the recording.
This will definitely come to you all.
Doctor, there are two questions on the chat box. One is from Palak. She is asking, turmeric milk is advisable to consume at night or start of the day?
Which one?
And after that, there is one more question. Turmeric milk is advisable to consume at night or start of the day?
Turmeric milk, actually, you can use it at bedtime because it contains the turmeric, the haridra. So when you use haridra at night, so there is one, what you can say, one saying in Ayurveda, Meheshu Dhatri Nishi, means you should eat the avalaki or this haridra at night. So bedtime will be more helpful for having turmeric milk.
Sir, one last question. Which is from Ramya on the chat box. She is asking, can we have raw or boiled vegetables at night?
I would recommend raw vegetables, big no. You can have boiled vegetables, but again, you season that boiled vegetables with the help of all these spices.
Okay. Next is Mr. Vijay Shetty. He's asking, can we take green tea instead of tea or coffee?
Green tea you can have. You can have this tulsi or this chamomile tea. I would definitely recommend green tea over normal tea and coffee.
Okay. Mr. Rupesh is asking, what will you suggest for those who are following two-meal plan?
So what I would recommend is for two-meal plan, again, but you can have this warm water frequently, this Ayush Kashayam frequently. At the same time, this two-meal plan also, they should not be too distant also. So at least 6 to 7 hours gap should be there between these two meals.
Okay. Mr. Sandeep Joshi is asking, can we drink turmeric milk if we are taking blood thickening pills?
Blood thickening, blood thinners, if you are taking, you can have turmeric milk, no issues. But if you have a tendency like bleeding nose, or you if you are facing some problem with the bleeding pills or the bleeding gums, so if the bleeding tendency is there of your body, then you should take with the caution, or you should consult the doctor, Ayurvedic doctor, and then you can have it.
Ms. Parnika is asking, how much time gap between dinner and turmeric milk?
Dinner and turmeric milk, you can have turmeric milk just before the bedtime. So ideal, there will be a gap of maybe 1.5 hours or so.
Mr. Rupesh is asking, which oil is generally preferred for daily use?
See, the oil we should use is always, it should be filtered and not the refined one. So if you get filtered oil, groundnut oil, sesame oil, ginger oil, or you can have this rice bran oil, always use the combinations of oil and not just one oil. So you will get all sorts of, all kind of fats in your meal.
Okay, Mr. Surya is asking, is it good to have fruits in breakfast?
Fruits in breakfast is very good. But whatever you are eating additionally in the breakfast, for example, upma or for example, idli, then you should not eat fruit and idli together. Then you should keep 1 hour gap at least. So maybe you can finish your breakfast around 8:30 and then you can have fruits after 1 hour.
Suggestion to increase weight? Shivam is asking.
First, you should concentrate on your digestive fire, your you see if your digestive fire is working properly or not. If whatever you are eating is getting digested properly, then and only all tissues will get the nutrition. So first concentrate on your Agni, whatever the practices, whatever the rules I have told you, whatever the tricks, the small tricks with the spices and all, whatever I have shared you, you just follow this for maybe a couple of weeks or so, and then you can have this Chyawanprash combinations to increase your weight, and you can try all these things.
One last question from Nikita is, turmeric milk in summers produces too much heat in the body. Do you suggest us to take it in these times?
See, what happens is, within only 1 or 2 weeks, the season or the climate is going to change. We are going to face the rainy season. So what happens is, right now, in rainy season, the vata will get aggravated. And it is in its previous condition right now. So even if we feel heat at this point, the turmeric milk will going to help us, as it will reduces the vata, and it will be better option to face the rainy season, to come over the seasonal allergies, this cold, whatever the routine flus. So to combat this, because turmeric has a very nice anti-allergic properties. So I would recommend you can use, if you are feeling a little bit more hot, you can put little bit less turmeric.
How giloy is beneficial for immunity?
Giloy is very good. Tinospora cordifolia, the guduchi, we call it as. And it is called as samshamanivati. So whatever the doshas, whatever the imbalance is there in our body, with giloy, with this gurvel, it calms down that imbalance, it improves the immunity. And we recommend for many people, as a prevention also, we recommend the samshamanivati or this giloy tablets. Just take the prescription from the Ayurveda doctor and you can have giloy.
What time to take giloy?
Giloy you should take usually in the morning time, because it is rejuvenation or rasayan kala. That's why the Chyawanprash is also recommended empty stomach early in the morning. So you should take giloy at least 1 or 2 tablets in the morning, empty stomach. And twice if recommended is required, you can have it at the bedtime also.
Giloy can be taken as tablet or giloy can be taken as a juice?
Giloy, if you get fresh giloy.
Sir, please post your question on juice. The chat box. Your voice is breaking.
Yeah, I'm getting the question. What I recommend is this giloy or avla or this aloe vera. So these are in the form of juices. They are available in the market. But what I feel is they are having little bit, whatever these juices, you have little bit good, you should have little bit more better Agni to digest all these things. So first you correct your Agni, your digestive fire, and then you try it, but you try it in the small quantities. Also, there are some restrictions, for example, for this aloe vera juice also, that you should not take it for prolonged use, because liver and is for intestines, it will little bit be more stronger.
Can we add sugar in turmeric milk?
You can add sugar in turmeric milk. For sugar, I would recommend for giving kids also, instead of using this refined sugar, which we get in the shops or grocery, we can go for this candy sugar. So candy sugar is available in the market. Rock sugar, we can say. Mishri bolte usko Hindi mein. Khadi sakhar, khadi shakkar. So that you can use, you can bring that, you can make the powder at home, and you can use that for the kids.
Priyanka is asking, ideal time gap between morning exercise and breakfast.
Ideal time, at least 1.5 hours to 2 hours you should keep between your exercise routine and your breakfast.
Anything on exercise appropriate for age groups?
See, I would recommend for all senior citizens should follow more of a pranayam, more of a meditation. So so more of the difficult postures, they will a little bit, they should do it with the caution. For adult, they can have any of rigorous exercise plus yoga postures of all this forward bending, backward bending, all this yoga postures they can have. And for kids, especially for kids, I would recommend they should do the Surya Namaskara. Surya Namaskara will be really helpful for them for their bone ossification, for their growth, for their height, for their digestive power, for their immunity. So if kids, they follow the Surya Namaskara and some yoga postures, it will be really helpful for them.
Any food to be avoided for migraine?
For migraine, you can avoid more of eating of a tur dal. You can avoid more of eating of methi, more of like some strong spices are there, like some garlic also you can have in proportion. So for migraine, you should not keep yourself, you should keep yourself like hungry for more time.
Okay. Thank you so much, doctor. I have put in my the email ID of wellness. If sure, you have any more questions, you can post it there and doctor will reply you on that. I think we should end the session. It's been a longer sure. session now.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, yeah.
So I think there's Thank one you, last doctor. Question yeah. by Surya. Sprouts and fruits can be taken together. Just answer this one last question.
Sprouts and fruits. You should keep some time between both of them. Sprouts you can have and you can take fruits afterwards. Fruits should not be combined with any form of food. That's the principle. Thank you for the session.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sneha.